you've been through, why you got scars. Since you walked through the door, I've been trying to reach you, 'cause I feel you. What's the story to tell? What's the story behind the mountain you're trying to climb? Think I've heard.
What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel, or if you are brand new here and this is the very first time you ever see my face, what's up? I am Jen. Today I am sharing another grocery haul and meal plan video with you guys. It is Christmas week, so it's going to be super basic, which you guys know I try to keep dinners extremely simple and basic all throughout the year, but we're like next level basic this week because obviously all the holiday festivities that's going on and family and all the other important things rather than cooking every single night in the kitchen. So I have super simple meals on the meal plan. Don't need a ton of stuff from the stores. I am not cooking a full Christmas dinner. My mom and my sisters are cooking some stuff too, so I'm just making a few casseroles and sides, which I'll show you guys what I am making. So a lot of the stuff I'm picking up is for Christmas dinner. So there are quite a few items that I don't purchase all throughout the year, but around the holiday times, Thanksgiving and Christmas. So I wanted to go ahead and show you guys what I was picking up and what we had on the meal plan for this holiday week. I hope you guys are having an awesome week and enjoying your time and your family and being present and not getting so wrapped up in all the chaos. I know that's hard to do. I have to remind myself also to slow down and just be present and soak up the memories rather than like worrying about all the things we tend to worry about through the holidays that aren't necessarily that important. Family and just spending that time together are what is most important. But let's go ahead and jump into the grocery haul. We did Winn-Dixie and Target this week. I didn't end up doing Walmart, which I was going to, but I did end up going there. I just ended up running into Winn-Dixie. I do have a couple things still to get from Publix, which I'll probably grab today or tomorrow. Those last minute couple items that I need to grab. But let's go ahead and jump into the video.
Okay, super quick, tiny little Target haul this week. Just a few things that I needed to get from there that I can't get from Walmart. And some stuff that was on sale, like these Yasso bars. You guys know I love these. The chocolate fudge ones are only 80 calories a piece, 6 grams of protein, and they have a 25% off cartwheel in the Target app this week. So I went ahead and got 3 because the kids absolutely love these as well. So I figured why not go ahead and stock up. Got some of the Siete grain-free chips. You guys know that my daughter loves. Some popcorn for the little guy. 2 bags of the boneless, skinless chicken breast tenderloins, the Good & Gather brand. I love. I have chicken a lot this week on the meal plan, so picked up 2 of those. Some more of the Tyson blackened chicken strips, just super easy for lunch this week. A couple packs of the lightly salted rice cakes, because you know these are mine and the hubby's obsession. A pack of the Sargento light string cheese. Some organic half and half for the hubby's coffee. A few of the Simply Pineapple Good Culture cottage cheese and a spaghetti squash. And that will do it for Target this week. Next up this week is Winn-Dixie. We'll go ahead and jump right in. Like I said, it's not a huge grocery haul this week, and most of it is for everything I'll be prepping for Christmas dinner, but a few things that I needed to get us through the week for our easy peasy dinners and lunches as well. So we'll go ahead and jump right in here. Couple English cucumbers, a pack of romaine heart to chop up for salads through the week. They were like wiped out of all their salad mixes, spinach, like all their greens were like wiped out. So I just grabbed this 3 pack of romaine hearts and that'll be perfect for salads through the week. Got a pack of squash and zucchini. I'll be making the zucchini and squash casserole that I made for Thanksgiving. I'll be making that again for Christmas. It turned out delicious, so super stoked for that. Some heavy whipping cream, some sour cream, some uncured smoked ham, some russet potatoes that I will be doing french fries in the air fryer. Some Velveeta cheese. OMG. I have not had this in like years, guys. Like years. But I am making a recipe that the family wants and it calls for this. So we went ahead and grabbed it. OMG. I used to love this stuff. It melts awesome, but it's definitely not the best. But again, a lot of these items are once or twice a year things and definitely not all year long. So we roll with it. Needed some more minced garlic, some Badia Complete seasoning, which you guys know is my fave. They only had these little ones, which it'll work fine. But I was glad that they had any at all because a lot of their stuff was wiped out. Some Badia chopped onion flakes, some of the light Hellman's mayonnaise, a can of whole kernel corn, as well as a can of cream style corn for my corn casserole. bananas, 2 boxes of elbow pasta for my homemade mac and cheese, 2 boxes of Jiffy corn mix that I use for the squash casserole as well as for the corn casserole, a humongous 1.5-pound block of the sharp cheddar cheese because I need cheese for everything. I actually still have a bunch in the fridge, but I always like to have an abundance of cheese because I literally throw it in everything when baking for the holidays. Got some of the 40-calorie a slice ultra-thin Sargento provolone cheese for dinner one night this week. Got a couple blocks of the Philadelphia cream cheese because I need that for my pumpkin rolls, spinach dip, all of that. I have some in the fridge, but I needed a couple more. And then I also got one of the containers because the kids like this because it spreads easier on the bagels. So I like to cook with these. They like to eat these on their bagels. Got a couple bags of wings. We haven't had wings a lot because they definitely are a little higher calorie, but they are like an easy, easy, easy dinner. Throw in the oven and forget about them. And that's what we need this week. So we are going in with wings and french fries one night. Then got a couple packs of butter because hello, all the holiday cooking. We need all the butter. Got some mountain bread for my spinach dip and then just a few of the foil throwaway pans for easy cleanup. So they didn't have, like I said, the spinach. I still need to get an apple pie, a couple things from Publix. Depending when I run into Publix and grab that stuff, I may include that in this week's grocery haul. If not, I'll show you guys over on Instagram. But let's go ahead and jump into the meal plan. Just kidding. We are not going into the meal plan yet because one of my online orders just came. Yes, please. American Dream Nut Butter. This was their launch. They just did. I got 2 of these French toast. I hope they are good. And I got 1 of these ginger doodle. I thought that I ordered 2. Now, I don't know because they only had a limited quantity that maybe they just only had 1 left. Or if I accidentally didn't order 2, I could have swore that I had 2 of the French toast in there and 1 of the ginger doodle. But I don't know. Maybe I messed it up. But this one is supposed to be like the goat in the bomb.com. And they ran out of it super quick. So I'll keep you guys posted on how both of these are. Okay, so I thought I only needed a couple last minute things at Publix. But it actually ended up being a little bit more than I thought. But that's all right. I went ahead and grabbed another one of these bread bowls. Because the one that I got, the mountain bread, I wasn't sure how it's going to be. This is a Tuscan bowl loaf. I'm probably butchering that. But I don't know. It just looked and sounded good. So, and we're going to have a bunch of people. So I figured that was awesome just to grab another one. Got some hot dog buns for the little guy. Got some baby spinach. They were buy one, get one free. So I went ahead and grabbed 2. I decided to go ahead and add deviled eggs to my Christmas menu. So I'm going to be making those as well. So I picked up a dozen of the cage-free eggs. Some all beef hot dogs for the little dude. Picked up a crunchy crab roll for my daughter, which I will also be splitting with her. Yes, please. Grabbed a couple bangs. They were 2 for $5. I haven't had the Miami Cola in a while, and I like this one. And they had Bangster Berry, which was the only other flavor there that I liked. We normally do cinnamon rolls every Christmas morning, but they were completely wiped out of like every single kind. And then last minute, I saw these 2 hiding in there. These are mini Cinnasticks made with real cinnamon, and it has 24 in there. I don't know. I thought they would be good and the kids would like those. So that works. Went ahead and grabbed a box of fruit snacks for the kids while I was in there. And this is the main thing I went in there. Dutch apple pie. These are mine and the hubby's absolute favorite. And you can't have an amazing apple pie without some good old Bluebell homemade vanilla ice cream. So, got 3 of those babies. I thought they were going to be out because Publix was insane and they have the best pies ever. But the lady had some in the back. So, that was a score. And then just grabbed some chips and popcorn for the kids. And that is everything for this grocery haul. Now we'll go ahead and jump into the meal plan. Okay, so here's the tentative meal plan for Christmas week. However, as we know, things can change, especially when you have all the festivities going on and super busy and all of that. So Monday, we will be eating out just fresh back from vacation. Taco Tuesday will be beef tacos with sweet potato fries. Wednesday, we will be doing buffalo wings and regular russet potato french fries in the air fryer. Thursday, we will be doing grilled ham and cheese with sweet potatoes in the air fryer. And then Friday, which is Christmas Eve, super easy. I'll be making peppercorn tenders. Just throw them in the oven with the G. Hughes peppercorn sauce. Super easy, and toss them on a salad. And then for Christmas dinner, the sides that I am making are zucchini and squash casserole, homemade mac and cheese, corn casserole, spinach dip with the bread bowl, a couple pumpkin rolls, and then the apple pie I'm not making. I'm just going to buy that from Publix. And then, of course, Sunday, we will still be doing all the Christmas leftovers. And then snacks, of course, for this week are pretty much the same. Built Bar, of course, which I think they still have some of their factory sale going on. So if you guys haven't checked that out, check out the link below. And with Jen, we'll say save you some money on top of their already awesome sale prices. And then we'll also be going in with string cheeses, Quest chips, Yasso bars, and rice cakes and nut butter, just to keep life super simple and moving through the holiday week.
All right, guys, so that will do it for this week's grocery haul and meal plan. I hope you guys enjoyed the video or got some ideas from it, or if you were just curious, everything that I picked up to float me through the holiday week, keeping me on plan and trying to minimize the chaos a little bit and keeping dinner simple through the holiday week, because as I said earlier, we all know how chaotic and crazy it can get and how wrapped up we get in all the festivities and getting all the gifts and doing all the things, and it just gets overwhelming. So trying to keep it simple and basic for your health journey and in the kitchen, I think, is crucial through the holiday week. So I hope this video helped you guys. If it did, make sure to give it a thumbs up. I hope you guys are all slowing down, breathing, and enjoying your time and your family in this Christmas season. It only comes once a year, and making all those memories and enjoying your family and yourself is so important. And while we enjoy all the food and the yumminess and all of this time of year, don't let it consume you throughout your day. Try to make the best choices that you can and just keep moving forward and enjoying this time, soaking it up. I hope you guys all have an amazing Christmas week and Christmas day with your family. And I appreciate all of you guys so very much. And if you guys want to see all the things I'm doing behind the scenes, make sure to hit me up over on Instagram. I'll be posting sporadically through the rest of the week and on Christmas. So definitely check me out over there at Imogen. And of course, make sure to subscribe before you leave. Make sure your bells click so that you guys don't miss out on all the upcoming fun of 2022. Can't wait for the new year. I definitely don't want to rush Christmas. I want to soak it all in, but I am excited for what's to come in the new year, and I know that you guys are too. So again, Merry Christmas to all of you guys. I appreciate all of you so very much, and I hope you have an amazing holiday weekend, and I will catch y'all in the next video.